Welcome. This is an overview of Light Manufacturing Solar Rotational Molding Technology. What is SRM, Solar Rotational Molding? In this process, we replace the use of fossil fuels for heating the mold and melting plastic with concentrated solar light and heat. In this shot, we see the SRM-4. This is our largest solar molding system. It's a self-contained, entirely off-grid molding factory. On the roof, you can see there's a 6-kilowatt photovoltaic system. This generates electricity, which is stored and inverted from a large battery. And that's for air conditioning, for running the motors that rotate the mold, for computers, that kind of thing. But heat is not generated by the PV array. That's generated by the heliostat array, which we see here. Now, what's a heliostat? A heliostat is a computerized sun-tracking mirror that keeps light steadily reflected from the sun onto a target. Each one of these can deliver about 2,000 watts of power, heat, to the mold. They're all focused on the mold, 48 of them. So we have almost 100,000 watts of heat that's being sent to that large tank mold right there, providing all the heat that normally is supplied by natural gas. So this is a revolutionary way to run your molding process without having to pay for fossil fuels. There's a shot of the array, and there's a shot of some product molded from the system. Now, where can we do this? About 40% of the Earth's land area is compatible with SRM. The darker red areas are ideal. So we have the U.S. Southwest, lots of Central and Southern America, much of the African continent, some of Asia, Australia, etc. And in all these areas, SRM allows you to mold with zero energy costs. Here's another view of the heat source, the array of H1 heliostats. Each is a 4x6 mirror delivering 2,000 watts of heat to the target. Arrays of these heliostats can be scaled from 100,000 watts of power up to 250,000 watts of power, which is roughly equivalent to 850,000 BTUs per hour of heat. This is a formidable heat source, and again, it's scalable to whatever a particular product needs. So on the left is the world we're used to. Depending on where you are operating, whether you have cheap natural gas coming out of a pipe near your facility, or if you're having to move liquid fuel around, energy as a piece of total product cost is somewhere between 5 and 25 or even higher percent. So here we have, again, the traditional model on the left where you're paying for heat, you're paying for labor, and paying for resin. And there's the SRM version of this where your overall costs have come down and your only direct product costs are resin and labor. This is a revolutionary change in the economics of rotational molding, which otherwise really haven't changed for about 50 years. Another key advantage of SRM is that it's very low CapEx, very low capital expense. You can see here a picture of an SRM-4 deployment, and it really looks more like putting farm equipment out into a field than setting up a traditional factory. And what's interesting is to note what's not here. There's no concrete pad, no steel building, no grid-connected gas or electricity or water. There's very little. What you have is a bare-bones factory-in-a-box system that takes about 2 weeks to deploy, and it can be installed on any disused land, an old parking lot, potentially the roof of another structure, etc. And what's interesting about this is you can also, if market conditions change, you can pack this system up and redeploy it somewhere else in about 2 weeks. So you don't have that one-time bet that you're making with committing to building a factory of the traditional sort. Also, with these relatively small granular units, you can put production capacity close to markets that are difficult to serve from a traditional factory, which reduces transportation costs and associated emissions. Here's an overview of Light Manufacturing's most popular SRM systems, from smallest to largest. All of these systems are two-chamber and, again, are completely self-contained, supplied with everything you need to mold, including the heliostat array. Just add plastic and your tools. First is the SRM-2, which is based around a high-cube 20-foot shipping container, Connex container. Moving up, we have the SRM-3, which is a 40-foot high-cube shipping container-based system. And finally, the SRM4, which you've seen previously, which is a super high modified 40-foot shipping container. This is the biggest containerized system that we can fit under U.S. standard bridges. Here's an example of a facility in Hawaii on the Big Island near the Kona Airport. As you can see, we're about 100 yards from the Pacific Ocean there and are producing product cost-effectively and out-competing a traditional local manufacturer who's having to bring in liquid fuel as an imported element. Here are some 950-gallon tanks molded at that facility. And again, key idea is we can locate factories near customers. A key advantage of SRM is that it uses standard tooling, aluminum or steel. A simple coating of high-absorptivity black paint allows you to convert any standard tool into a solar rotational molding tool. This is a key advantage, site scanner software. Leveraging a massive U.S. government database of solar intensity by half-hour time slices across the world, we can, on a very fine grid, predict output for a specific product at that location. So you could have a really good understanding of how many 1,000-gallon water tanks are you going to be able to produce at a given site, month by month, as you can see in that graph there to your upper right. Again, this tool lets you scan an area where you might want to deploy capacity, and it'll show you with this color-coded series of dots, you know, red dot, don't deploy there, orange, getting better, green, quite good. And then when you click on one of those green dots at a particular site, again, it predicts for you on a monthly basis what your expected output will be. SRM has some real technical advantages compared to traditional molding. Because we are radiatively heating that mold, not heating the air around it particularly, you can put advanced electronics of several types right into the molding chamber. Again, that's because the air in there doesn't really get hot. You can stand inside the molding chamber while molding is happening and be perfectly safe. So that means we can drive motion of the tool with servo motors or stepper motors, which allow for precise robotic positioning and movement of the tool in the chamber. And that means, since we can move the mold the way we want, we can choose to slow down as the bottom of the tool enters the beam and then restore normal movement as we exit the beam. So therefore, we can actually put more heat into the bottom surface of the mold and therefore build up a thicker layer of plastic on the bottom of the tank. And likewise, if we want to, we can program the system to automatically speed up a bit as the top of the mold passes through the beam, producing a thinner top surface where less strength is needed. So this is a really powerful level of automation that we can implement, per face thickness control. A related advantage is because of the lack of high temperatures, we can permanently install full-time multi-channel temperature monitoring into the system. So this means every single cycle is being molded to a target peak inside air temperature. We're not putting a temp logger or something similar in there, assessing a few cycles and then setting a time for a process. Rather, we're molding each cycle to that target temperature, ensuring a perfect cure. This is critical for our process because, of course, early in the morning versus midday versus in the evening, solar intensity changes quite a lot. And so we have to adapt our cycle time to achieve that target temperature. And likewise, if there are a few clouds going by, there are other solar intensity changes through the day, our process automatically adapts the cycle to get a good cure. And the operator is not required to babysit the process, which is a huge advantage. Other advanced automation includes the ability to automold to the target piot, as we discussed, and also cooling is automated. Once we've started the cooling process, our thermocouples will monitor the inside air temperature, turning on fans automatically, and cool to that target temperature, at which point motion stops, the mold goes into its perfect demolding orientation, and a signal is played for the operator to know that it's time to extract that part and put in more plastic and inserts. So it's really powerful. Again, we can store multiple movement recipes in the system per product. So one temperature profile or movement optimization can be stored for a particular product, and you can have a completely different recipe for a different product. So it's not one size fits all. You've got a highly customized movement and temperature recipe for each product you're molding, which is fantastic. We have a full IP stack, everything from our heliostat design and software up through the site scanner, through the actual solar molding system itself. So we've got a deep basis of knowledge about how this is done, and we've been doing it commercially for over 10 years. Systems can operate entirely off-grid with local Wi-Fi only connecting everything together so that you're running the operation from your cell phone or from your laptop. But also systems, if needed, can connect to the web so that remote operators can upload new recipes for a product so engineers can download data, etc. As we've mentioned, there's a deep level of automation, which means very low operator training burden and high reliability to the overall system. We talked about site scanner. And a key thing is our systems have sufficient PV power and massive lithium ion batteries and inverters to drive AC systems so that you can run a second shift as it's getting into the evening hours. You can have secondary operations being done, cutting holes, finishing product to a ready to sell state, palletizing it, and all that can be done with light and electricity supplied by the system. And the entire system is designed to be highly field serviceable and reliable, with simple to maintain reflectors that can be field swapped, and with standard machine components that are easy to maintain. So one prominent industry figure who I won't name has described SRM in general as the most advanced rotational molding systems in the world that just happen to be solar powered. We think that's an accurate statement. Our next presentation is an overview with a bit of a technical deep dive. So thanks again for listening. And again, this is our overview of SRM technology in 2024, presented by Light Manufacturing.